everyone, we are the Paradoox, welcome to our channel. In this video, we are going to learn how to make material for the pirate No. 1, and finally render it at Arnold. If you want to learn how to make the pirate No. 1 on the Marvelous Designer, we uploaded a video of how to make it on our channel, you can also see that. If you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to it and hit the notification button, so you do not miss our future videos. Well, let's not waste any more time and go to it. Save the output as OBJ without characters. Select the single object mode and choose one of the three modes, thin weld, thin unweld, and thick, based on our needs. Thick mode in thick parts, its UV is not defined. So in the case of thick output, it is better to define UV thickness separately for other parts in that software. UV is applied to this output, but it is not set as UDIM, and we need to identify each of the UVs and define it as a polygroup so that we can create material on each of the UVs separately. Now it's time to start materializing. Open the Substance Painter and enter the low poly model. If we have a model without thickness, it is better to change the type of shader, so that the normals appear on both sides of our screen. Now we see in which of the polygroups we specified, it is applied as a texture list. Now it is time to bake the high poly model on the low poly model. In the baking section, we define the high poly model of the selected section, and we bake the normal, ow, curvature, etc. maps as needed. Pay attention to the size of the bake maps and not all of them need to be in their largest size. After we bake all the parts, we start making materials by creating layers. We start by determining a general color for the clothes, and for more details, we can add the mask and generators, as well as the procedures, and combine them using blending modes, to achieve the desired result in producing the original color. The same process can be done for other sections, for example, for fabric details and protrusions in its layer, activate height and add a special texture to produce the desired material. And we can make big changes in them by using level and filters. The warp filter is used to create disorder and imbalance in the environment. This filter can be used so that the material is not homogeneous. Other filters such as blur, sharpness, bevel, etc. can also be used, and by combining these, we can achieve the desired material. To add clearer noises and irregularities in the material and add fine and messy details, it is better to use noise textures or grunge and adjust them manually. There is another type of this detail called a smart mask, which cleverly creates a series of details and irregularities based on bake maps. Using these items is very useful in some situations, but it is not good to overdo it. Using generators is also very useful. Generators such as dirt and fiber, automatic stitches, and UV borders are very useful and are used in many projects. You can also use the smart materials in the software itself and change it to your desired material by turning off and on its layers and changing them. Ordinary materials also exist, which are widely used in the construction of the basic material base, and in some cases, simple materials are used and gradually become a professional material through a process. After finishing the materialization, you can add sewing lines on your fabric with generators such as auto stitch. You can also add custom layers by adding a paint layer manually and with different brushes on the fabric. Now the material is finished and the next step is to output the textures. Because we do the rendering process in Arnold, we set the template to Arnold, and if we needed opacity or illumination maps, we had to add it manually to the outputs, and finally output the textures. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope this video was helpful to you and could have added something to your information. If you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to it so that you do not miss our future videos. If you like this video, please like it, it will help us a lot. If you have any questions, you can say them in the comments section. So I will see you in future videos.